Hi everyone and welcome back to another meal, another video, okay? I thank you for coming and I'm very hungry so I may just do minimal talking. I know it's hard to believe. So what I have for you today is comfort food. Now the weather's getting a little colder now and one of my favorite foods is low calorie and very tasty, so hot and so creamy. It's congee juk. I have here kimchi juk, congee with kimchi. And if you like kimchi, if you like kimchi stew, if you like kimchi pancakes, you'll love kimchi juk congee. And this is my first meal today, so. And I have homemade steamed dumplings from Senior Granny, and I have ginger, pink ginger, seaweed, you know the seaweed salad that you eat with sushi, yellow daikons, and kimchi. So let me give you some crunches, okay, today. Dear God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the meal. Bless this, Lord. Bless this, Lord. Help this meal to nourish my body, and bless everyone that is here today, Father God. Lord, you know their every needs. We thank you for all of your blessings that you give to us unconditionally. Lord, we thank you for everything. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, I don't want to spill any. It's congee, okay? It's like runny oatmeal. And I like my congee really, really thin. I don't like it too thick. And when I eat my oatmeal, I make it really thin. So let me do my thumbnail, get that out of the way. I added some sesame seeds and green onions. All together. Okay. And I have not just soy sauce, but whenever you guys eat dumplings, pot stickers or whatever, mix vinegar with your soy sauce. It's much better. Really hot. And this is homemade. So if you have fermented kimchi, up really small. Make rice, pre-cook your rice. Traditionally, you get the dry rice, add water, and you stay by your stovetop, you know, stirring for a very long time. Nobody's got time for that. This granny does not. So I pre-cook the rice. And then I add a lot of water. And then I cook it on the stovetop until it gets like this. And then I add the kimchi and cook it some more. Add some salt and beef stock, okay? Dashida. People say dashida's not healthy for you. But I need my food to taste good. If the food is not good, I'm not gonna eat it. Just like coffee. Some people, they like just no sugar, no cream, just black coffee. I drink coffee because of the taste. If I had to drink black coffee, I would not drink coffee, period. This black coffee is healthy for you, I'm sure. But I need my food to taste good. How about you guys? You have to try this. And if you have an upset stomach and you're not digesting food very well, ginger is good for that. But congee is good when you lose excuse me, when you lose your appetite. When you fast for a few days or a day or two, whatever, and you can't just put, you know, solid foods in, right? You eat congee. In Korea, when you're ill, when you have a cold or something, friends or family members will always bring you congee, juk, you know, vegetarian juk, abalone juk. And I have a video with abalone congee too. I think I have a video of everything. I have over 600 videos, 580 or 600. Who's counting? Oh, nice. Always need this. Everything here is so good. And older people that do not have teeth, this is good for them too. And Senior Granny, she makes the wrappers out of flour. She makes the dough and makes everything all fresh from scratch. Colors are so pretty. Watching the timer. What sound do you like the best out of these four? Ginger. Crunchy by itself. Lastly, the pot sticker. Mandu or pot sticker. What else are they called? Wontons. This is mandu. Drink. Gatorade. try to be elegant, but it's not for Granny. Eat a lot of ginger, it's good for you. It helps with your digestion, and also it boosts your immune system. So if you have a loss of appetite, or if you're sick, you don't know what to eat, make some kimchi porridge, chuk, congee. Put a lot of water in rice. Pre-cook your rice. Add a lot of water. Boil, stir. And you know, I even have a shortcut. If you don't have time for that, which nobody got time for that, right? You mix in the water with the rice. As you're boiling, get a handheld blender. Just blend it. Just blend it and let it boil. That, you can make congee in less than 20, 30 minutes. 20 minutes, I think. I made it that way before. But I was going to make this that way too, but I accidentally put the kimchi in first, so I didn't want to grind up the kimchi. So I had to do it the old-fashioned way, and I stood by the stove and to make it under 25 minutes. I think many people struggle with trying to make their videos long. I struggle with trying to keep mine short. because I like to eat slowly and I like to talk a lot. I don't think I talked as much today, did I? Let me know. It's kind of strong. Thank you for staying this long. Might as well like, comment, and subscribe, okay? Join Team Granny, okay? And let's eat some good food. Thank you. May God bless you. And until the next time we get together.